Hello one, hello all, Sim Reaper here, welcome back to the channel and welcome back to European Countryside. And I hope you all have a great Friday, because it's Friday. Today, we've got a few bits to do. Mainly, we're going to be selling our soybeans. And we also have some harvesting to do. So, we're going to take the John Deere. Go sell these soybeans because they're at a really good price right now. And we have 20 something thousand litres. When do I sell the eggs? Let's have a look. Eggs sell best in November, okay. So I've got a few more months before I have to sell them. Right, so I've got 81% full. So we're going to head that way. I'm going to go sell those. To get the honey off the rack. I tip over because I always forget about the realism mod. It's a good job I'm not like playing this realistically. The amount of times I've tipped over. Hell, I tipped over in the middle of mining. Go the normal way over the rickety wooden bridge. Seems like the best bet. I'm very tempted to remove them. Roads. Well, we're going has the best price at the moment for soybeans. Sell there. Alrighty. So our next job will be 93,000 pounds plus 7,400 for the environmental score award. Nice. So that's what? That's 100,000 basically. Gives a bit more leeway. To sell soon, because we've got some harvesting to do. I really could do with a bigger harvester, in all honesty. So I think I may lease a bigger harvester. may have a look around for some collectibles just to give us a bit of an edge. I know I found a few. I think I'll save that for when I'm desperate. We're alright for now. I can use the current harvester, it just takes a bit of time, that's all. So we've got wheat field there. No, sorry, barley there. This is wheat here. We've got canola in front. And then we've got another wheat field near the farm. So I'm park this up here for now. I want to see what's ready. So that's growing. Right, so the barley's ready to harvest. And the wheat's growing. Okay, so we're going to harvest the barley first. Let's park this up here. Go grab the harvester. Because why not? I also want to replace that cedar as well. I've got a nice modded one. It's essentially the same cedar, but it acts as a plant as well. It can plant everything pretty much. For now, let's go grab our barley. Started, shall we? As you can see, it's quite very, very slow, this thing. So, yeah, we're going to have a look into getting a new harvester, I think. £239,000. I'll probably just lease one. I won't get much for this vehicle. It'll be something. So I'm going to drive this back down to the store. I will see you once that's done. Alright, so we're at the store. And we're in position. Let us sell. So, let's see what harvesters are available. I have some nice modded ones. But that was not too bad. I could actually just buy that straight out. But the problem is, I'm not going to have much left over. Ooh. Try not to sneeze, do apologise. Yeah, I think I'll go for my Colossus. Compared to the others, it's probably the best to go for, but I'm not gonna go mad. I'll just leave it as it is. 15,000 litres. Keep all the normal settings, because I don't want to spend more than I have to. Right, So I want a header that's got twice the width that these were using, at least. So that's a 5 meter. So I want a 10, maybe 15 meter. Headers. 13. Let's have a look at these honeybees. 9.1, 11, 12, 13, 15. I'd say, no, let's go 12 meters, I think. Canola knives. Cross auger. Sure what that was. Prairie wind. Whoa. Height control. Yeah, that looks beastie. That's expensive too. Right, 12 meters should be more than enough. If it's big, I can always replace it. Ah. Need a trailer for it. What the hell? Okay. Let's go check it out. Why is that so small? I hope it stretches. It's actually quite a large header. Size of that header, that is ridiculous. So you do have to unfold that. Okay. So how is it this head that header is the right header for? Let's start by getting it hooked up and then see if I can extend it, because that's the only thing that makes sense. I mean, how's that supposed to support the weight of this otherwise? Or can I even attach it to this? Okay. Something down here. What we got that I can bring down? Not much. Oh, actually, I could bring the fast track down. Because I don't really use that for much. Let's have a look. Little steering. I don't see like any special actions. Strange. thought you'd maybe be able to extend it or something. I mean, if it doesn't work, then I'll just have to grab a different header trailer, but this header's quite large. But, I mean, the trailer needs to be, like, at least that long. So there's no way this trailer's for that. Maybe the smallest version. So, see, look, the clusters are separate, back and front, so that there has to be a way for them to for it to extend. See a way, so it must be in the tractor itself. What the? Oh, that's cool. Okay. None of the above. Let's have a look and see if there's any controls for it. Okay, so I did a little bit of research on how to actually use this trailer, and it's actually surprising that I didn't think of it sooner. Although, I mean, you wouldn't just think about this off the top of your head. To be honest, I've never used anything like this before. So let's go into harvester. That's as high as it's going to go. Right. So what I want to do is I need to go around the front. Careful on the turns. I'm going to go around the front like this. After that, reverse it in. So, and then jump into the harvester. Attach it there. That, jump back into here. Around this end here. This little piece in. Did I not line that up properly? I think I did. There it is, and boom! We have ourselves an attached header. Okay, so I'm going to take the harvester up first. arrive on this harvest. Alright. So the harvester is up at the farm. So now we've got to take the header up. I've always wanted to try these honeybee headers. This is the first time I've ever used one. Let's just hope it's not too crazy going through here. I do with some fuel actually. Let's do the simple thing and we'll hit cruise control. Should be more than enough. I'm just glad this fast track can pull it without any issue. This medium fast track it's just a really useful little tractor. You can do all sorts of things with it. Just my luck to get stuck in that one hole. So I'm going to have to put it across here, like so. Right, so. Simply just reverse. Oh wait, no, we have to go around to the other side. doesn't make sense why I have to do it that way, but fair enough. Get harvesting, shall we? First load is almost done. Perfect. Let's jump over to the John Deere. That's going to be it for this episode. If you like what you see, please feel free to like and subscribe, and I will catch you again next time.